Thanks for tuning in today to this special edition of Google Developers Live. Today we have Joshua and Cortney Woodword joining us as the GDG Fresno High organizers, and later we'll have some of the student members of GDG Fresno High joining us in celebration of Computer Science Education Week. I am Van Riper. I work with our Google developer groups around the world as their community advocate, and I've worked with Josh for a long time as one of our GDG Fresno organizers, and today Josh and Cortney are going to tell us about how they got started with GDG Fresno High.
That's correct, Van. Being a part of GDG Fresno, we were involved with adults and already established programmers, and we wanted to get high schoolers involved, and my wife is a teacher at a local high school, Fresno High, and so I approached her and asked, how do we start a club and get kids involved, and how can I come on campus and teach kids how to code?
And Cordy, you were saying how at the beginning, how, you know, the challenges you had to start with.
Well, absolutely, because to be a club sponsor, that's above and beyond your teaching responsibilities, your classroom responsibilities. So a lot is on your own time, coordinating with other adults on campus to get the club started, to get a meeting place. And in this case, one of our greatest obstacles was getting computers in front of the kids so they could actually code.
And then you told me how this year, how it's really taken off. You did the Club Expo at the beginning of the year.
And right. So since it was new and there was no sort of tech club on campus, we didn't know where to start. And at the middle of last year, we said, well, we're just going to go for it. So we got the paperwork in and recruited a few kids. But it was really hard to get the word out, and we didn't have computers. This year, however, at the beginning of the year, we did the Club Expo. I had Josh's Google Glass on. That really caught kids' attention. And we had over 60 students sign up that were interested in some sort of aspect of technology or computer science or just learning more about Google products.
And how often do the students meet?
Now we meet once a week. On average, about once a week, during lunch or after school, in a computer lab where we have access to computers. We started off just by showing them like the video on code.org, mm-hmm. and you know, they get really inspired when they hear like free food and they get to play pool all day. So that got them hooked into the club. But now we do actual hands-on stuff. So like we built a tic-tac-toe game in JavaScript. And walk them through that step by step on what everything that's going on.
That's great. And you also told me that you did something kind of unique. I think you might be one of the first, you are the first high school group that we've ever had. We've had many university chapters, but GDG Fresno High is our first chapter within a high school. But you were able to get Google Apps for Business, for education, for the...
Yeah, so we have a domain, FresnoHighWarriors.com. And it has a Google Apps for Education account tied to it. So somewhere in the requirements, it just said you had to be a school organization. And so that's what we were. So now the students get their name at FresnoHighWarriors.com, and they have access to Google Drive accounts and Google Docs, and we can actually open up a doc and plan a meeting and share.
And how much did that cost?
That's free.
That's right, it's free. So at the schools out there, if you want to start a chapter like this at your high school, if you work with an organizer like Josh in your area, because we don't allow under 18 people to organize groups, but if you get an adult organizer in your high school, you could potentially get these Google Apps for Education for your students as well, which is great. I think that's a great thing you guys did.
Yeah, that's one of the things is why it worked, I think, is because my wife was a teacher on campus, so it was easy to get in that way on campus. So it's just a matter of getting somebody that's on campus. So if you're a teacher on campus and you want to start a club, go to the Google Developers Group directory and see if there's a chapter in your area and contact that organizer and work with them, probably.
Yeah,
it's
great.
The best.
So maybe now we should actually talk to some of the students about their experience with the groups. Sound good?
Yep.
And we're back with Fresno High School students, Chris, Marshawn, and Riley. So Chris, tell us about how you got started coding.
Oh, well, I was really bored for about a month during summer, and my grandma was reading the newspaper, and she saw this thing called 59 Days of Code. And it was downtown in my city, and she took me down there. And there was a man named Jake Soberall, and he is starting a new course, and he teaches kids how to code because he says that there's not enough people that are coding. So there needs to be much more. back to you, Van.
Thank you, Chris. So how about you, Marshawn? How did you get started?
I got started coding by, like, when I was little, I used to always mess around with technology, you know. You know how little kids are. They like to do different things. Don't know which one to pick. So, you know, like, when I got to Fresno High, you know, I used to go to the library, like, every day during lunch, after school sometimes, sometimes before school. And I never heard of the GDG program that Miss Woodward had going on. She found me. So I was like, yeah, I'll join. So the first day, it was on Thursday, I went, it was like a variety of different kids. So I was like, I probably can fit in. Cause it ain't just for like one kind of kid, no geeks or nothing. You can football players, basketball players, anybody. So I joined.
That's great, Marshawn. So how about you, Riley? How did you get started?
My stepdad, Josh, started me on Code Academy on, like, online, and I played around with that for a little while and then sort of lost interest in it. It seemed a little bit out of my league. Like, it seemed I had so far to go. It kind of discouraged me a little bit. But when the club started, it actually, like, it helped me realize how, like, I could find my place and, like, do things at my level. I didn't have to be a master at anything. I could just work at with what I had, and it would be enough. So it really encouraged me to do more. So
great. So what keeps you coming back to GDG Fresno High?
I just really like coding, and I like my teacher that teaches that. And I don't know, I think the kids are really nice, and it's really like good in there. Everybody can fit in.
Great. How about you, Riley?
Well, it's like the next big thing. It is the big thing, and it will be for some time, I think. Like, it's computers and Google and developing, and it's not gonna be out of style or something. Like, next year it'll be around, and it'll keep growing and keep getting better, and I'd like to be part of that.
Great. How about you, Marsha?
I agree with Riley. Computers is gonna be around for a while. It's like, it is the new thing. Like, you're going to see, sooner or later, you're going to see everybody with the computer. You're going to see everybody doing the coding. It's like, I like the atmosphere. Everybody around me is, like, smart, intelligent, bright. I like that.
So do any of you have any final thoughts? Anything, like, actually speak to your peers out there, students, maybe at other schools, like why you think they should get involved in something like this?
Yeah, I think everybody should be a part of coding because it's going to be, like, the future, like, I think everybody's going to code mostly. Like, you should do this if it's available.
I'm going to say, like, try something new for a chance, you know? Like, don't keep doing the same thing over and over because sooner or later it's going to get boring. Like,
Yeah, sort of along the same lines. Even if you think it's, like, too hard or you have a long way to go, you just keep working at it. And even though you're a beginner, you can still contribute in some way to either your community or to some project. So just don't get discouraged about it.
Well, that's great. Well, I really appreciate your time, Chris, Marshawn, and Riley, for coming out and telling us about your experiences. And I'd also like to thank Joshua and Cortney Woodward, as well as the Fresno High School, for their support in this first ever GDG Google Developer Group chapter in a high school. As you could see from the discussion today, you know, students really warm to this. They really are passionate about learning about technology, and we really like to see many more groups like this be inspired by what we heard about today. And you can participate by going to csedweek.org and joining in an hour of code during Computer Science Education Week.